Hello everyone. Today we will understand the basics of stroke localization, basics part 1. CNS in general seems a very tough topic, especially for the MBBS students. But most important is if we know the neuroanatomy, physiology, it is a very easy topic. So let's start with this part of stroke localization, part 1. And most important is the physiology, anatomy of the pathways. This is a very important diagram to understand how to localize the different syndromes or the site of lesion if there is a stroke. So first we understand that the brain is supplied by arteries, anterior cerebral artery, middle cerebral artery and posterior cerebral artery in pairs. Looking at the coronal section of the brain, this is a coronal section of the brain, and this is the medial part and this is a lateral part of the cortex. The representation of different parts of the body, medial part we have lower limb representation, then we have trunk representation, upper limb representation and the face representation. So let's see how these fibers they descend. These fibers we can call as the cortico-bulbar or cortico-spinal pathways. Starting with the lower limb, the lower limb fibers they descend through corona radiata and they go to the posterior limb of the internal capsule and they are located laterally. This is the lateral most fibers and you trace these fibers of the lower limb and they go through midbrain, pons, medulla. And below the medulla, they turn to the other side. They turn to the other side and they supply the other part, opposite part of the limbs, lower limbs. Similarly, for the upper limbs, if you can trace this line and it goes again via internal capsule and through the midbrain, pons, medulla, it descend and just below the medulla it goes to the other side and supply the upper part of the limb, upper limbs it is supplying. Now look at the face representation. The face representation fibers they go through again internal capsule and from the internal capsule they pass through the midbrain and from the midbrain they go to the other side of their nucleus, that is the seventh nerve nucleus which is located in the pons, and they supply the respective part of the face. And this there is a unique property of the facial muscles being supplied. The upper part of the face has a bilateral representation. So if there is a unilateral lesion, upper part of the face is spared, while the lower part of the face will be affected if there is a upper motor neuron lesion, because lower part of the face has unilateral representation. So if we look at these arrangement of the fibers, I have intentionally drawn the motor pathways because it is mainly the hemiplegia or facial plegia which is seen in a patient of stroke. Here I can make the diagram of one part of the face like this. This is one part of the face I am drawing here. This is the eyes and this is the other side of the face. This is the left side of the face. So what happens, the fibers, the seventh nerve nucleus fibers, they will supply the right side of the face, and from the opposite side we have the fibers which are coming from the opposite side. They cross from the opposite side, and then they will supply this side of the face. So remember, the upper part of the face has a bilateral representation. Bilateral representation. So if there is a upper motor neuron damage, it will be spared. It will be spared. But lower part of the face has unilateral representation. It will be affected. And from the below the pyramids, here is the upper limbs and lower limbs. Upper limbs, lower limbs. So this is the representation that I have made from this diagram. So let's see one by one. If the lesion is in the cortex, so what will happen if it is a cortical lesion? Of course, the opposite side of the face will be affected if it is a cortical lesion, and opposite side of upper limb and lower limb will have weakness. Will have weakness. So if it is a cortical lesion here, there will be opposite side of the face, and opposite side of upper limb and lower limbs will be affected. And if it is internal capsule, again, if there is a damage here, you can very well see the opposite side of the face, and the opposite side of upper limb and lower limb will be weak, or they will be affected. Now, about the brain stem, that is the midbrain, pons, and the medulla. If the lesion is in the midbrain, then the upper part of the opposite side of the face, upper limb and lower limbs will be affected in that scenario. But what happens? So, till the midbrain, if there is any damage, any lesion, so opposite side of the face, that is a lower part of the face, and opposite side of upper limb and lower limbs will be affected. But what happens when the pons are affected? So if pons are affected, this is the site of the nucleus, that is a lower motor neurons of the facial nerve arise here. So what will happen if there is a lesion in the pons? So suppose it is a left sided lesion, so left side of the face will be affected. Left side of the face will be affected, but the opposite side of upper limb and lower limb will be affected if the lesion is in the pons. Similarly, if the lesion is below the pons, what will happen? Face will be spared. Face will be spared, and opposite side of upper limb and lower limbs will be affected. Opposite side hemiplegia or hemiparesis will be seen. So in summary, if the lesion is at the cortical level or at the internal capsule or at the midbrain, opposite side of the body will be affected, including the face, upper limb and the lower limb. If pons are affected, then the same side of the face will be paralyzed, but opposite side of limbs, upper limb and lower limb, will be affected. While if there is a lesion in the medulla, in that case face will be spared, because the above fibers are not damaged. We will get in medullary region the opposite side of upper limb and lower limb will get paralyzed. So this is a gross overview of localization of the stroke, and the details we will discuss in part 2 of stroke localization. So this was a very basic to make your fundamentals clear about the hemiplegia, and